Hello and welcome back to the Mullooly Asset YouTube channel. Thanks for tuning in. In this video, we're going to talk about whether you can continue to work and receive your Social Security benefits. Make sure to like and subscribe. Thanks as always for tuning in, and here you go. But if you make too much money, then some of your Social Security benefits you won't receive the full benefit. So the income threshold here in 2024 is $23,320. So if you earn anything over that, your Social Security benefit will be decreased. I'm going to share my screen here again and have you guys walk us through the example of how those benefits will be calculated in the future. So
I'll say, as this is coming up on the screen, that Brendan and Tim have popped some people's bubbles in the sense that they have walked in with the concept that, hey, I'm going to retire. I'm going to pick up this other job that I've got lined up, and I'm going to file for Social Security at the same time. And they're 62 or 63. And when we tell them, hey, some of this money's going to get clawed back, you're going to have a problem, it's a real eye-opener, folks.
Yeah, and the further above the threshold you are, the less likely it makes sense for you to do both of those things, both collect Social Security before your full retirement age and earn some income from employment along the way. Notably, though, something like your pension or taking money from retirement accounts during that period of time is not going to impact it really is just earnings from employment. And so it's important to separate the sorts of income that you have and think through how they all factor into the overall retirement plan. And that's one kind of wrinkle here to be aware of, I think.
Yeah, good distinction there. So the way that it works is that your Social Security benefit is reduced by $1 for every $2 you earn over the income limit. And that might make your head spin. So let's walk through an example. So let's say on the screen here, your Social Security benefit is $12,000 a year. You earn $35,000 from employment, so wages, $35,000 a year. Earnings limit is that $23,320. Got to calculate how far you are over the earnings limit. In this example, you are $11,680,000 over the income threshold. To determine what your benefit's going to be reduced by, divide that by two. So your benefit's going to be reduced by this number, the $5,840. Subtract that from what your benefit is, and you're going to get $6,160, which is just over 50% of your actual Social Security benefit. So you're only going to get about half of your benefit if you have this amount of earnings per year.
Yeah. So maybe there's a world where that reduced amount of income is enough to bring it all home for you in terms of, covering your cost. And that's your only option. There's nothing else you can do to get that income that you need. And the reduction is fine. So you choose to collect anyway, but you have to do the math to figure it out, because in a lot of cases, the reduction that you'd be eating makes it not worth it to collect early. You do end up getting some of those benefits that are held back during this period of time. They come back to you past your full retirement age. But if you're talking about the present and what you're going to need to do to make ends meet, you have to do that calculation, Kate, that you just walked us through. If you don't, then you're going to be in for an unpleasant surprise.
So important to understand your cash flow. And a reminder that this is for folks who are thinking about filing early before their full retirement age. So if you are in a position where you can wait to file until your full retirement age, for a lot of people now it's becoming 67, you don't have this clawback situation going on. It's only for folks who are looking to file early.